అసలు మనసు నుంచి ఇష్టం ప్రజలు అధరాన్ని జవాబు కానీ కాలం లేక పిల్లలకి ఉపదేశిస్తారు. సో మనుషుడు మేడ్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణాస్ నేమ్ ఫార్మ్ పాలిటిషన్ కాస్టెన్స్ బికాస్ నేమ్ నేమ్ ఫార్మ్ పాలిటిషన్ కాస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ ఆర్ నాట్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ హిమ్. సో దేర్ ఫార్ మనుషుడు వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్లీ అటెంటివ్ వైల్ చాంటింగ్ ద హోలీ నేమ్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ. సో రమణ గోస్వామి టోల్డ్ హిమ్ దట్ యు షుడ్ గో టు యువర్ హోమ్. You should go to your home because you don't have full faith in the holy name of Krishna. So when we are chanting the holy name of Krishna, we should understand that Hare Krishna. Hare is Radha and Krishna is Krishna. So Radha Krishna, we are serving Radha Krishna together when we are chanting the holy name of Krishna. So then Narottamdas Thakur, he did the Vigraha Prachar. He established the deities in Bengal, Manipur and other areas and he wrote very powerful kirtans like Premasa Chandrika and others. When he would perform kirtan, Radha Krishna themselves along with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all their associates would manifest during his kirtan and they would participate in the kirtan. But though the body of Narottamdas Thakur was fully transcendental, he manifested the pastime of being paralyzed at the end of his life. So seeing that he was paralyzed, some people began to criticize him because Narottamdas Thakur was not from a Brahmin family. However, he had many Brahmin disciples. So therefore people told him that because they initiated Brahmins, Krishna has punished him and therefore he has been paralyzed. So his disciples began to lament. They said, alas, our Guru has been severely criticized by this. So they complained to Narottamdas Thakur and then Narottamdas Thakur exhibited another pastime. He immediately got up and went to the Ganges River to bathe. So then all the people who were criticizing Narottamdas Thakur, their mouths were shut tight. So actually one time some Brahmanas, they came, they wanted to debate with Narottamdas Thakur. They wanted to tell that Brahmanas are superior than Vaishnavas. And so they have this pride of dharma. But as Mahaprabhu said, Kiva Vipa Kiva Nasa Chutra Kiva Jai Guru Sandha Vipa Jai Guru Vaya. That no one is Brahman. Mahaprabhu also told, Naam Vipra Vachana Pati Naam Vaishya Vishudra. Nova Vata Nasa Guru Pati Vanastoya Dirma. So Gurudev has, so it has been, so when these people who were from Brahmin family, they came there to debate, so what happened that some people, some disciples of Narottamdas Thakur, they took the dresses of different shopkeepers. So when they came to the shop, actually, when these Brahmanas came to the shop, these disciples of Narottamdas Thakur, who were in disguise, replied to their questions in Sanskrit language. And they defeated all these so-called Brahmanas. So when they went to purchase, they went to the market, wood market, they saw that even the woodcutters and the people selling wood, they were also speaking in Sanskrit language. Seeing this, these Brahmanas were wonderstruck and they thought that if the people who live in the village of Narottamdas Thakur are so learned, so scholarly, who can speak in Sanskrit and know all the scriptures, all the scriptures cover to cover, what will be the condition of Narottamdas Thakur? He must be a very exalted scholar. So they all ran away before even seeing the face of Sri Narottamdas Thakur. So Sri Narottamdas Thakur had a very excellent disciple. In his life was Srila Vishwanath Chandra Thakur, who was the Shiksha disciple of Sri Narottamdas Thakur. He was very scholarly and very expert in Sanskrit. So he has written three books, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu, Ujjwala Nilamani Kiran, and Bhagavatamrita Kana. It has been said that these three books represent Vaishnavism. If anyone has studied these three books, it means he has understood the mood of Srila Rupa Goswami. And if one has not studied these three books, then he has not understood what Vaishnavism is. So Srila Gurudev has translated these books into the Hindi language, and from Hindi that they have been translated into English and other languages. So we should take advantage of these books. So in very simple, straightforward, and very clear language, Sri Srila Vishwanath Chandra Thakur has expressed the thoughts of Srila Rupa Goswami in his books, and they are very easy to understand. Srila Vishwanath Chandra Thakur, he went to Vrindavan to perform bhajan. But his guru told him that you cannot perform bhajan in Vrindavan, first go and seek permission of your wife before you come to Vrindavan. So he went, he returned to Bengal and he went to his wife, and for entire night he told us very sweet Krishna Katha. Hearing the sweet pastimes of Lord Krishna from the lips of Vishwanath Chandra Thakur, by the morning time his wife was fully convinced that she should let her husband go to Vrindavan. And his wife told that we can go to Vrindavan, and I think you should also pray that something auspicious will happen by the mercy of Krishna in my life. So he protected Vishwanath Chandra Thakur. He is actually not different from Prabhu Goswami. So he has actually, he's called Mahamahopadhyaya. And he protected the original stream of Vichardhara, the original stream of thoughts in our line. So Rupa Goswami, has, in his books, has established Paratya Bhava between Radha and Krishna. And, but Sri Jiva Goswami, he was a disciple of Sri Rupa Goswami, he wanted to protect this Paratya Bhava from the people who are not qualified. And to save people from committing offense at the lotus feet of Sri Radha Krishna, for the unqualified people, he gave some meanings of some verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, the meanings which were actually suitable that would represent the Swatya mood of Sri Radha Krishna. So, but he actually, also in Gopal Champu, and also on his commentary in Ujjwala Nilamani, Srila Jiva Goswami has some places expressed the Swatya Bhava, so that the people who are not qualified, or the disciples who are not qualified, will understand that Radha Krishna's pastimes are Sakya. However, Srila Vishwanath Chandra Thakur very clearly in his commentaries and all his books, such as Sri Krishna Bhavanamrut and other books, express that the love between Sri Radha and Krishna is extramarital, that is actually Paratya mood. So one time, some people in Vrindavan were very much angered to hear that Sri Vishwanath Chandra Thakur has expressed that love between Radha Krishna is Paratya. So therefore they wanted to get rid of him. Every day Sri Vishwanath Chandra Thakur would do the Panchakrosi Parikrama Vrindavan Dham. And one time he was passing on the Parikrama Marg, and there was some dense forest there. And 5 or 6 people were hidden there, and they wanted to kill Vishwanath Chandra Thakur. So as soon as they saw that this elderly Vaishnava is coming, they appeared in front of him. But immediately he vanished from there, and they saw a small girl there, very small, like 10 or 12 years old. Teenage girl they saw there. So they asked that girl, "Dali, Dali, have you seen that elderly Vaishnava was passing from here?" And she said, "No, I have come here by the order of my Swami from Javad. My Swami is in Javad. I have come here to bless flowers." And after that, she disappeared, and Vishwanath Chandra Thakur was there. They immediately realized that this is a Mahatma who is actually living in the Gopi there. So they immediately fell down at his feet and asked for his forgiveness. Another greatest contribution of Sri Vishwanath Chandra Thakur, apart from his books, was his disciple, Sri Baladeva Vidyabhushan. So Sri Baladeva Vidyabhushan was the greatest scholar of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. And he was sent to Ghatakarni in Jaipur to protect our Sampradaya. Ghatakarni, actually some Ramana Sampradaya people, some Ramana Sampradaya scholars have convinced the king that Srimati Radhika was not married to Krishna. Nowhere in the scripture is that written that Radhika was married to Krishna. So therefore it is proper to take away the deity of Srimati Radhika from the left hand side of Sri Krishna. So Sri Vishwanath Chandra Thakur was exhibiting the pastime of becoming old. So therefore he sent the disciple and commander-in-chief of Gaudiya Vaishnavism, Sri Baladeva Vidyabhushan, to Ghatakarni. Baladeva Vidyabhushan was very thin in his appearance. However, he was very strong in his learning. So there, he cut all arguments of Ramana Sampradaya scholars and established that Sri Radhika is the Swaro Shakti of Krishna and she must be on the left hand side of Krishna. So later on, this Ramana Sampradaya devotees they told that in your Sampradaya, there is no commentary on Brahma Sutra, Vedanta Sutra. So then, Baladeva Vidyabhushan replied that according to the authority of Garuda Purana, that commentary, the spotless commentary on Vedanta Sutra is Srimad Bhagavata itself. And Gaudiya Santas have accepted Bhagavata as the commentary on Vedanta Sutra. However, they were not satisfied. So then he pleaded to Lord Govinda. He said, please give me the time of 7 days. So they gave him the time of 7 days. And he went in front of the deity of Govinda and requested Govinda to manifest this commentary on Vedanta Sutra. And in one night, Govinda dictated and Baldev Vidyabhushan Prabhu wrote down very beautiful commentary on Vedanta Sutra called Govinda Vashya. And then all these Ramana Sampradaya scholars, they understood that Baldev Vidyabhushan Prabhu is very empowered and they accepted their defeat and Srimati Radhika was established on the left-hand side. He wrote a book called Vashya Pitak. This Vashya Pitak book, if someone will study, then you will understand Brahma Sutra very nice. So Vishwanathini Thakur has written a commentary on Bhagavad Gita called Sanatana Varshini Tika. And that is very excellent as a vichar. And we are proud that our Gurudev, our Srila Gurudev, has written, has translated this commentary into the Hindi language. And it has also been translated in English language. See, Baldev Vidyabhushan wrote the commentary on Bhagavad Gita, which is based on Tattva Vichar. So Srila Gurudev is ordering us that we should study the books of Srila Vishwanathini Thakur. Srila Gurudev has said that he has translated many, many books of, almost all the books of Srila Vishwanathini Thakur, except for Sri Krishna Bhavanamrita Kavya, for which we are not qualified yet. So we went to the Radha Gokulananda temple. There is the Samadhi Peak of Srila Vishwanathini Thakur. And also there is a Govardhan Shila, which was given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Raghunath Das Goswami, Govardhan Shila and Gunja Mala. That Govardhan Shila is also present there in Radha Gokulananda temple.
Brihat Bhagavatamritam. अब तक हमने साधु संघ की महिमा बताई, छठा का साधु संघ हमारे जीवन को बदल देता है और राधा कृष्ण के चरणों में प्रेमा भक्ति देने वाला है। बिना वैष्णव के चरणों में अभिषिक्त हुए शुद्ध साधुओं के चरणों में कि पत्थुरी से स्नान किए बिना कभी भी भगवान की कृपा नहीं मिलती है। इसका हमने श्रीरूप सनातन गोस्वामी श्रीमद भागवती और दूसरे दूसरे श्लोकों से हमने बतलाया। बृहद भगवतामृत दो खंडों में है। इसको महाराज परीक्षित मृत्यु के निकट आने पर अपनी मैया उत्तरा को सुना रहे थे। जब यह उपाख्यान दोनों समाप्त हो गए तो वे श्रीमद् भागवत के चुने हुए गोप और गोपियों से संबंधित कृष्ण के रसात्मक भावों को के जितने भी श्लोक हैं उनका वो पाठ करने लगे और उसकी व्याख्या। जैमिनी जी ये परीक्षित के लड़के जैमिनी जी को ये कथा सुना रहे थे। उन्होंने कहा, तुम्हारे पिताजी ने अपनी मैया को अंतिम समय में भागवत के परम रसात्मक श्लोकों का जो श्रवण कराया था मुझे सुनाओ। जैमिनी जी कह रहे हैं कि उन्हीं श्लोकों को मैं उच्चारण करता हुआ विश्व में सब जगह घूमता हूं और मैं सारे दुखों को भूल जाता हूं। मैं तुमको ये चीजें बतला रहा हूं। यह कह करके उन श्लोकों को जिसको रसायन कहते हैं, भागवत के जितने भी अच्छे अच्छे गोप और गोपियों से संबंधित श्लोक है इसमें वर्णन किया है। पहले सबसे पहले वे ब्रह्म संहिता के दो तीन श्लोक पहले बताते मैया को कह रहे हैं और मैं आप लोगों को कहता हूं, गोलोक में हम लोग आप लोगों को ले चलना चाहते हैं, सब लोगों को। तो जहां पर जाएंगे तो उसकी रूपरेखा तो जाननी चाहिए कि वहां पर क्या है, नहीं है, कैसा है स्थान। इसलिए परीक्षित भी अपनी मैया से गोलोक का वर्णन कर रहे हैं कि गोलोक कैसा है, कृष्ण अपने परिकरों के साथ में कैसी लीलाएं करते हैं।